Hello friends, today we will see example of FP tree. FP tree stands for frequent pattern tree. FP tree construction is the first step in FP growth algorithm. In this example, we have to construct FP tree. For that purpose, we have given some transaction and minimum support count as 2. You can see we have given 10 transactions in our table. First transaction contains 2 items, item A, item B. Second transaction contains 3 items, item B, item C and item D. In first step, we have to find out individual items present in our transaction table. So you can see here we have element A, element B, element C, element D and element E. Total 5 items. There are total 5 individual items present in our data set A, B, C, D and E. In next step, we have to calculate support count of each item. Now, what is support count? Support count means how many times particular individual item come in your transaction table. For example, I have to calculate support count of A. So, I will check how many times A comes in this transaction table. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. In this transaction table, A occurs 7 times. Therefore, support count of A is 7. Similarly, we count for B, C, D and E. Now, support count is also called as frequency of particular item. So for that reason we will make table of 2 columns, item and support count. As calculated, A has support count 7, also B has support count 8, C has support count as 7, D has support count as 5 and E has support count 3. Now we have given the minimum support count as 2. So we will check whether all the items support count is greater than or equal to 2. If item has support count greater than or equal to 2, then all those items are taken for the next step or for the construction of FP tree. Here you can see all 5 items A, B, C, D, E has support count greater than or equal to 2. Therefore, no item is removed from this table. Now we will move to the next step. In this step, we have to arrange the items in descending order of their support count. If you see, B has largest support count as A. So we will take B as first, then A has support count 7, after that C has support count 7, B has support count 5 and E has support count as 3. Here you can see A and C both have the same support count as 7. So here you can also take C first and A latter. The order doesn't matter, but the order which you take here is taken for the further processing. Here I am taking A first and C later. So our order of item becomes B, A, C, D and E. In the next step, we will arrange all our transactions according to the priority of support count. For that purpose, we will make table of three columns with TID items and ordered items. Our first transaction is A, B. Here A had support count 7 and B had support count 8. According to descending order, B has the highest priority. Hence, ordered list became B, A. In the second step, item list is B, C, D. Here, if you look at the previous table, you will see B has highest priority 8. After that, C has priority and after that, D has priority. Hence, the ordered item list remains the same. Same for the items A, C, D, E. Next transaction is transaction A, D, E, which will also remain the same. Now, for this transaction A, B, C, here B has highest support count. Hence, B comes first, after that A, and after that comes C. In the next transaction also, B had support count higher than the ACD. Hence, B comes first. After that, A has higher priority, then C and then D. Now, again here, A and C has same priority. But in the first table, we have taken the order as B, A, C, D, E. Hence, we will follow that rule. We will take as B, A, C, and D. Next, BC remains same. Similarly, all other items are arranged according to the descending order of their support count. And this ordered items list is taken for further processing of FP tree construction. Now, here onwards, we will begin our construction of FP tree step by step. For that purpose, we will again make one table with three columns, item, support count and node link. Here you can see I have taken item in descending order B, A, C, D, E. The order is same as I have taken previously. I have noted support count of all these elements and I have created one more column as node link which is currently blank. Now, our FP tree construction begins. FP tree starts always with the root node. Remember, root node of FP tree is always null. Now, we will go for the transaction 1. Our transaction 1 is path BA. So, we will draw path BA from the root node. So, from root, we have created or we have added two new nodes to our FP tree, B and A. We have taken their count as 1 because we have created them as a first time. After that, we have created new node. Hence, we will give node link to the both nodes. Here, node links are given to the all newly created nodes. Hence, for the B, we have given node link from the table and also for A, we have given node link from the table. Again, second transaction is B, C, D. Now, again here, we will check whether we have found B from the root node. Yes, we got B from root node. But we don't have nodes C and D. Therefore, we will add two new nodes C and D with respective count as 1. Here, notice I have incremented count of B by 1. So, it becomes 2. So, B's counter is now 2. Here, we have added two new nodes to our FP tree, C and D. Hence, we will give node link to both of them from the table respectively. Next transaction is ACDE. Now we will check again from root node. We have any node A. In the last step, we have only created node B from the root node. Here we don't have node A, hence we will add path ACDE to our FP tree. We will give count of them as 1. A count 1, C count 1, D count 1, E count 1. Here remember, nodes are different. We have already ACD in our FP tree, but paths are different. Hence, for this path, A has count 1, C has count 1, D has 1, and E has 1. Now again, we will assign node link to this newly created node. Here in diagram, you can see I have shown node links from the blue dotted arrows. Now you can see newly created node A has got node link from the previous A node. Newly created C node has got node link from the previous C node. Node link node D has got node link from the previous D node. Here node E has got the node link from the table, because till now we have not any E node created. Now next step is ADE. Now we know, or we have find out node A in last step. Hence we will go from root to A, and we don't have the path DE. Hence we create two nodes DE with count as 1. Here we have visited A 2 times, hence we will increment counter of A by 1, so it becomes 2. In this step, or in fourth transaction, we have derived 2 new nodes in our FP tree. Hence we will give node link to these 2 nodes D and E from the previous nodes D and E. Now fifth transaction is B.A.C. Here we have already path B.A. So we will include C as a new node. We will increment counter of B and A by 1. So now counter of B become 3, counter of A become 2, and C is newly added node. As C is newly added node, we will give node link to this C from the previous C. Now in the sixth transaction, we have the path BACD. So again we will trace from root node. We got B, increment counter, so it is created as 4. Next, move to A, increment counter, it becomes 3. Next, move to C, increment counter, it becomes 2. And last, add new node D with counter 1. In this step, or in this process, we have generated or added 1 new node to our FP tree. Therefore, we will give node link to this D from the previous D. Now for 7th transaction BC, we will trace from the root node. We got both the nodes B and C. Therefore, we will increment count of both by 1. Therefore, count of B becomes 5 and count of C became 2. Here we have not added any node to our FP tree. Therefore, no node link is provided in this step. For 8th transaction, we have path BAC. We already have this path in our FP tree from root node. So we will increment only counter. Therefore, B's count becomes 6, A's count become 4 and C's count become 3. Here also we have not added any new node to our FP tree. Therefore, there is no addition of any node link. Only count is incremented. For path 9, we have transaction BAD. Here from root node, we have traced the path BA. So counter of B incremented by 1, so it becomes 7. A's counter become 5. And we have added new node D with count 1. Now in this step, we have added new node D. Therefore, we will give node link to this new node D from the previous node D. Again, I will tell you, node links are shown by dotted arrows. For the 10th transaction, BCE, we have traced path BCE. We have incremented counter B as 8, C as 3, and we have added new node E to this FP tree. Again, I said we will add node link to this newly created E from the previous E. Here, our construction of FP tree is completed and our final FP tree will look like this. You can also check whether your example is correct or not by looking at this FP tree. Now here you can see B has support count 8. So in this tree we have got B as support count or count as 8. Next, A has support count 7. So you can check A with count as 5 plus A with count as 2. 5 plus 2 becomes 7. So this is also correct. Now C has count as 7. C has support count 7. So we will again check C with count as 3 plus 3, 6. 6 plus 1, 7. So this is also correct. Next, D has support count 5. So we will check D 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1, 3 plus 1, 4 plus 1, 5. So D had support count 5. This is also correct. And finally, E had support count 3. So E 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3. So all the items with its support count are tally and all are correct. Hence, our final FP tree is correct. This is our final FP tree. So the things to remember in this example, that root node is always null. Node links are always shown by dotted arrow and path are always traced by our normal arrow. If you like my video, please press like button. Thank you, and also subscribe to my channel for more such example video. Thank you very much.